Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with next topic of unit number 2. The name of the topic is three-phase converters. In our previous lecture, we have completed single-phase converters. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to see following subtopics. We are going to see three-phase semi-converters with R-load, three-phase full converters with R-load, power factor improving technique and boost converter, dual converter. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra, I'm having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of 10 years. Let's start with three-phase semi-converter for resistive load. This is the circuit diagram of three-phase semi-converter. It consists of three thyristors T1, T2, and T3 and three diodes D1, D2, and D3. So half part consists of diode. So this is semi-converter. We are giving three-phase AC supply. So it is three-phase semi-converter. Load is resistive. So input will be AC, output will be some kind of pulsating DC. Let's understand with the help of waveform. So we are giving three-phase supply. So here in the waveform, we can see the three phase. Here A, this is B, and this blue line indicates C. Now, if we see the output, then this part of the input is appearing across the output. This part of the input is appearing across the output. And this part of the input is appearing across the output. So this is some kind of pulsating DC we are getting across the output. Next is three-phase full converter for resistive load. This is three-phase full converter resistive load circuit diagram. It consists of six SCR, SCR1, SCR2, SCR3, SCR4, SCR5, and SCR6. We are giving three-phase AC supply from the input and we will be getting pulsating DC across the load. This is the input voltage waveform where we are giving the three-phase supply and this is some pulsating DC which we are getting across the load. As the circuit consists of six SCR, so we have to give six gate pulses which are different for different SCRs, starting from IG1, IG2, IG3, IG4, IG5, IG6, which are respectively for T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, and T6. Next is power factor improvement techniques. Power factor is defined as the ratio of active or useful power to the total power supplied by the source. Some of the power factor improvement techniques are semi-converter operation of full converter, asymmetrical firing, and force commutation. Force commutation means we are connecting some external devices or circuitry across our main circuit or main component due to which the device gets turned off. That means we are forcing the device or circuit or component to get turned off, hence the name has been given as forced commutation. Forced commutation are further of three types. First, symmetrical angle control, SAC, extension angle control, EAC, and pulse width modulation, PWM. Next is boost converter. A boost converter, step-up converter, is a DC to DC power converter that steps up voltage while stepping down current from its input supply to its output load. Basically, it is possible to obtain multiple outputs from a boost converter as well. Diode rectifiers are most commonly used circuits for those applications in which AC supply is used as input. The example of such applications are computers, telecommunications, air conditioning, and fluorescent lighting. But the demerit of diode rectifier is that its power factor is high, typically 0.9 for resistive loads, but it reduces for reactive loads. However, with the help of modern control technique, we can improve the input power factor to make it as close as possible to unity, that is one. We will see the principal operation of the circuit. The input current of the boost converter is controlled to follow the full wave rectifier waveform of sinusoidal input voltage by using PWM technique. The gate drive circuit for MOSFET M1 produces the PWM control signals by using bank hysteresis, BBH technique, which is similar to the delta modulation. The reference signal or current is generated from the error voltage VE and input voltage VIN to the boost converter as shown in this figure. Next is dual converter. You can see the figure. This figure shows a dual converter. It consists of two converters, converter 1 and converter 2. That means we can connect either two single phase converter or three phase converter together. So we can get a circuit which can operate in four quadrants, means all the four quadrants. Here, this is a complete circuit of a dual converter and this is the waveform. This side is converter 1 and this side is converter 2. Let's see first the converter 1. If alpha is less than 1, alpha is less than 90 degree, this circuit is going to act like a rectifier. That means output voltage is positive, output current is positive. If alpha is greater than 90 degree, then this circuit is going to act like an inverter, or it will work in inverting mode. Therefore, output voltage will be positive, but output current will be negative. The device is going to operate in quadrant 2. So for converter 1, we are getting a circuit which is going to operate in two quadrants, quadrant 1 and quadrant 2. This is used for regenerative braking. Now see converter 2. If alpha is less than 90 degree, then current will be negative, voltage will be negative, device is going to operate in fourth quadrant for alpha is greater than 90 degree. If alpha is less than 90 degree, then current will be positive but voltage will be negative. In that case, device is going to operate in third quadrant. This will be like if we are getting voltage negative, current negative, direction of rotation will get changed. And also it is going to use for regenerative braking also. Here with this waveform, we can understand the operation of dual converter. We are giving the input AC supply over here. We are triggering this, we are getting the output voltage. This is for alpha less than 90 degree. Here, this is for alpha greater than 90. In this lesson, we have learned three-phase semi-converter for R-load, three-phase full converter for R-load, power factor improvement techniques, diode as boost converters, and single-phase dual converters. Thank you.